Well, hello everyone. My name is Jayraj and welcome to Spring Boot tutorial series by JR Academy. Before starting this series, I want to tell you a few things about this series. So this is a beginner level video course, and in this course we're going to look into some of the basic concepts of Spring Boot, and later we will create a small project so that will help you to understand all the concepts. And this is a video course, so I prefer not to repeat same thing again and again, because if you miss something you can always go back and look into it again. And you can put your questions in the comment box and I will try my best to answer those questions. So let's get started. So this is an introduction tutorial, and in this tutorial we're gonna look into why we need Spring Boot and what we can do with Spring Boot. But before starting about Spring Boot, let's see a little bit history of Java and what we can do with Java. So Java is a programming language that was created in 1991 by James Goslin, and the initial name was Oak, and later it was changed to Java. And Java is an object-oriented programming language. So what is object-oriented programming? I assume you all know. Otherwise, I'll create another video and put a link into description for your reference. And there are so many versions of Java, and currently latest version is Java 13. But in this course, we're going to use Java 1.8 or Java 8, because in industry, still there are so many people using Java 1.8. So there are three platforms of Java basically. So those platforms are J2SE, Java Standard Edition, J2EE, Java Enterprise Edition, and J2ME for Java Mobile Edition. So let's look into what we can do with all these platforms. So with Java Standard Edition, we can create a standalone application such as calculator in your machine. If you open your calculator in your machine, you can see this calculator is not doing anything advanced, like it is not storing any data, it is not communicating with anything else, it is just calculating whatever numbers you are giving. So that kind of application we can create with J2SE. And moreover, we can use Java Standard Edition's socket programming feature to create client server applications. So if you go in hospitals or schools or libraries, you can see all machines are networked with each other. So we can create application for the network communications and network thing. And another platform is Java Enterprise Edition. So this is important for us, because with this we can create web application. Now, what is web application? So you know our bank application and our ticket booking service. There are a lot of out there, but this is the basic examples. If you open your bank account, you can log into it, you can transfer your money, you can do a lot of things with it. So that is a web application. And another thing is this application you can create such a way that they can communicate with each other. So you can, let's say for example, take a ticket booking application, and ticket booking application, we book ticket on some other application and it will buy a ticket in the actual platform. So let's say if you buy some movie ticket, which some application is giving you some discount, so in background that application is communicating with the actual application, and that's how it is going. And for more example, you can see when we buy ticket, it asks for our bank details, our account details for money. So basically that application is communicating with your bank bank application to get your details and your money and everything. So that kind of application we can create with J2EE. And third one is J2ME, Java Mobile Edition. So this platform is used to create applications for smaller devices such as mobile device or embedded systems. So this all things we can do with Java's different platforms, but for us J2EE is important, and web application is important for us because Spring Boot framework is for web application. So now let's move forward and see what is web applications. If you look around, you will see so many web applications such as Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, LinkedIn. These all are web applications. Currently, you are watching this video on YouTube, and YouTube is one of the web applications. In web application, there are so many different parts. So let's say if you open your bank account in your browser, you can see all the UI, all the button is there, all the text field is there, all the images is there. It's a UI, it's a user interface. But the data is coming dynamically from backend. So let's say if I open my account, I can see my data. If you open your account, you can see your data. So this data is coming dynamically from backend, and UI is showing the data to you. But this data is stored somewhere in database. So basically what is happening, backend is fetching this data from database and doing some process on the data and giving this data to UI. So this all three layers is communicating with each other. Sometimes there could be another systems which is communicating also with backend, but overall this three layer is the main. This architecture could be a different from application to application, but the higher level this architecture will be same. At every layer we are using different kind of technologies. So for UI, we normally use HTML, CSS and JavaScript, and nowadays people are using Angular and React. For the backend, we can use Java and frameworks such as Spring and Spring Boot, and Python we can also use, which is with a Django framework. And for database, we can use SQL or NoSQL database. But we are interested in the communication between backend and UI. So this communication is happening between the APIs. With the API, so this API is basically a URLs that UI can fetch UI can fire and fetch the data out of it, and this data will be in the form of XML or JSON. So with Spring Boot, we can create RESTful APIs that will help UI to give them data dynamically. So what is RESTful APIs? We will look that into the future. So but overall, this is the architecture of the application. So in 1990s, people were using EJB. EJB is Enterprise Java Beans, which was a framework, but it was a huge and it was like very difficult to understand and difficult to learn. So in 2002, Spring was released. Spring was originally developed by Rod Johnson, and initially it was named Interface 21, but after that it was changed to Spring because EJB was like winter and nobody likes winter, and Spring is always amazing. And currently it is handling, it is organized by Pivotal Software. And if you see the logo, it is like a leaf in the Spring, and this is their official website. So let's see what they have in this website. So Spring's official website is spring.io. If you open this website, you will see a lot of things about Spring framework. What you can do with Spring, you can what you can achieve with Spring. There is so many things you can see here. And if you go in this project for tab, then you will see a lot of main project which is going with Spring, such as Spring Boot and Spring framework, Spring Cloud, Spring Data, Spring Batch, security, mobile, Android, lots of things is going on. So you can visit this website, see what is going on, and you can see all the documentation and latest updates about the Spring. I highly suggest to look into this website and see what is going on and learn more about this. So let's get back to our tutorial. Those all were the feature of the Spring. And Spring became a pain because of configurations it requires. If you actually code with Spring framework, you will see you need to do a lot of configuration to start the framework. And before starting the actual coding, you need to spend a lot of time in just configuration, which is sometimes painful and sometimes confusing also. So that's why Spring came in the picture. And there are other problems also with Spring, which we can solve with Spring Boot. So what is Spring Boot? So Spring Boot is basically a smaller version of Spring framework, and it will give you inbuilt configuration that you can use most of the time. 80% of the time we use same configuration. So instead of doing that, those configuration ourselves, Spring can give you by default. And there are other features also with Spring Boot, such as you don't need to deploy a WAR file. It doesn't require XML configuration. It creates standalone application. It has a Tomcat server inbuilt. So what is all this point? If you don't know anything, we will look into that in future. But overall, Spring Boot was a very good framework to start our application quick. And I suggest, before ending this video, I suggest you all to go the Spring's official website and see what are the features with the Spring, what are the other project is going on with the Spring, and what you can do. There are documentation, a lot of documentation. You can look into it and read about this. So that's all for now in this tutorial. And so thank you very much for joining this tutorial series, and we will meet again. And till then, like, subscribe, and keep learning. Thank you very much.